Hello children, welcome to my English session. In our last class, we have completed 5th standard Ivan story part 1. Today we are dealing with Ivan story part 2. In part 1, we have covered the paragraphs, the grunt, mud and the protector. Today we are going to cover the paragraphs, the perfect life, the end, wine, the temporary human and the hunger. Without wasting any time over here, let's read the paragraph, The Perfect Life.
The Perfect Life. Gorilla babies, elephant babies and human babies are not so different, except that a gorilla gets to spend the day riding on his mother's back. Slowly, carefully, a young gorilla begins to go further and further away from the safety of his mother's arms. He learns the skills he will need as an adult. How to make the nest of branches, weave them tightly or they will fall apart in the middle of the night. How to beat your chest, cup your palms to amplify the sound. How to move from tree to tree, don't let go. How to be kind, strong and loyal. As a young gorilla, you make mistakes, you play, you learn. You will do it all over again. It was, for a while, a perfect life.
In the paragraph, The Perfect Life, Ivan or the mud is explaining that what all the things they are going to learn as their baby, as their babies over here. Here, baby gorilla, that is mud, is saying that human babies, elephant babies or the gorilla babies are brought up in the same manner, that is in the group. Here, gorilla babies are brought up in a troop. And human babies are brought up in a family. And they are learning so many things by looking at the troop members here. And slowly they move away from the safety of their parents and they are becoming independent now. And what all the things they learn, gorilla babies here, are how to make nest of branches. These are the skills they need in future. Those things they learn when they are babies only. How to make nest of branches to sleep in the night. And how to beat the chest. Actually, gorilla babies, they give signals to the other troop members if there is any danger. So, they'll make a cup out of their palms and they'll beat against the chest. So that they'll make an enhanced sound or a great sound. So that the nearby troop members can hear that one and they can move away from the danger. So that one they learn, making signals, making sounds and amplifying it, making the sound greater, like that. Then how to move from tree to tree. How to move from one tree to another tree in search of a fruit or something else, or to save themselves from any danger. All these skills they learn in the perfect life. And slowly and carefully they are moving away from the parents and they are becoming independent. Here, gorilla babies or the human babies cannot learn or develop the skills at a time. Like that only, here baby gorillas, mud and tag, they also do many mistakes and they'll be playful and they learn more and more things. They'll not learn everything at the first go. They'll make mistakes and they are guided by the parents, that is silverback and their mother, and they learn the things slowly and slowly. Till then, everything was very good. They were very happy in the wild with the troop members. It was a perfect life for mud and even for tag also. And then one day, what happens? Everything was still over there and it was so much still. That means they can hear the sound of the air also. At the time, what happened means human came.
Here, Ivan is narrating the story. He is telling that everything was okay till one day when humans entered the jungle.
The end. One day is still day when the hot air hummed, the humans came. One. After they captured my sister and me, they put us in a cramped dark crate. Somehow I knew that in order to live, I had to let my old life die. But my sister could not let go of it. She kept thinking about our home all the time. When one day I noticed her looking at me without really seeing me, I knew she was completely lost.
In the vale means the plain area where the grapes grow. As we pack fruits, no, in the big large wooden container, like that they caught, they trapped mud and tag and they kept in that big crate, wooden box like thing that we call it as a crate. In that they put them, and as the young gorillas, the mud and tag, they cannot learn all the things or all the skills at in a first go or in a single day. They made mistakes, they did the things over and over, means again and again they practiced. They were guided by the gorilla parents and they were learning so many things. They were playful, they were making so many mistakes and they were learning also with that. And they were happy with the troop members. Everything was fine. Everything was perfect. That's why Mud or the Ivan is calling this paragraph as the perfect life. Then what happens one day? Everything was good. Everything was okay. And there was a still silence over there in the forest. It was so much silent that they can even hear the sound of the moving air. And on that day, humans entered that forest and they captured Mud and Tag. They wanted to keep them as a pet, so they captured them and they put them in a wooden crate. Crate means a big box. As we pack fruits, no, grapes, apples and other fruits we pack, no, like that. They trapped them, they separated from their parents and they were put in the crate. Here, Mud, he adjusted to the situation immediately. But Tag, she could not adjust herself to the situation, new situation here. She can't forget the wildlife and she can't forget her parents and she goes into depression. Means she will be always sitting still only, looking at only one place. But Mud, he was little bit intelligent here and he wants to move further in life. He wanted to be alive and he wanted to experience his life. So he adjusts to the environment and he copes with the human beings. What happens next? We'll see in the next paragraph. Let's know about few words and meanings here. First one is crate. It's a large wooden box for transporting things. To take the things from one place to another place, a large wooden container is used. That is called crate. Here, Mud and Tag, after captured in the forest, they were put in that wooden box. It was very dark inside and was very less space to move around. That is about crate. Next, cramped. Small and crowded one with not much room to move. Mud says that the crate was cramped, means it was very dark and very less space to move. Somehow, Mud adjusts to the new environment and he will cooperate with the situation and he will be looking forward for the what about his future. But here, Tag, she could not forget her old life, that is forest life, father and mother and the wildlife. She could not forget that one. She goes into depression. And within no time, she completely loses her senses and she dies.
The temporary human. It was Mac who opened that crate, Mac who took me, and Mac who raised me like a human baby. I drank from a bottle, I slept in human beds, sat in human chairs, listened while human words swarmed around me like angry bees. Mark's wife, Helen, was quick to laugh but quick to anger too, especially when I broke something which was often. I broke the blender when I squeezed the 3 tubes of toothpaste and a bottle of glue into it. I broke my toes attempting to swing from a lamp fixture on the ceiling. I broke 46 glasses well. It turns out there are many ways to break a glass. Every weekend, Mac and Helen drove me to a restaurant where they ordered something for me. I went to baseball games, to the grocery store, to a movie theater, even to the circus. They did not have a gorilla. I rode a little motorbike and blew out candles on a birthday cake. My life as a human was an exciting one, although my parents would not have approved.
In the paragraph, the temporary human, Ivan is telling that it is a person by name Mac who opens the crate, who takes the mud, and he is the person who gives the name Ivan to him. He took that mud to home, and mud was brought up as a human baby. He used to wear human clothes over there and used to drink milk from the feeding bottle. He used to sit on the chairs as the human baby sit, and he used to sleep on the human beds. Everything completely different from the forest. He has brought up like a human baby over here. Mike's wife Helen, she was also a good lady, and she also took very good care of Ivan here. But sometimes she used to get angry with the mischievous deeds of Ivan. What all the mischiefs he did means he broke glasses, not one or two, nearly he broke 46 glasses. Once he broke the blender also, that is mixie. And once he squeezed the toothpaste tube completely, and once a gum bottle or the glue bottle also. And once while jumping here and there inside the house, he broke his toe also. So during that time, Helen used to get angry and he used to scold Ivan. But the very next moment, she was very tender, very loving, and she took very good care of Ivan. And even Ivan was very happy here in the new human environment, as he has got the parents like Helen and Mac. In the weekends, he used to go for the long drive with Mac and Helen. See how lucky he is, Ivan here. Next, they used to take him for restaurant also, and they used to order something for Ivan also. We can make all these things make out in the picture. And he went to grocery shop also. He went to baseball camps also. And even he went to the movie theater also. And even he went to circus. But for his luck, there were no gorillas in that circus. So he is saved there. So he was enjoying each and every moment in human life. It was an exciting one. Even he had a small motorbike to ride inside the house, and he celebrated his birthday also. He blew out the candles and he cut the cake also. And he was growing up, or he was brought up like a human baby with Helen and Mac.
Hunger. In my new life as a human, I was well taken care of. Yet at night, laying alone in my pajamas, I longed for the cheerful grunts of a play fight and the easy safety of my nearby troop. Remember what happened to Dad? I told myself, don't think about the jungle. Still, sometimes I lay awake wishing for the warmth of the another just like me.
The paragraph, the hunger means not physical hunger, that is appetite or eating things. It is the emotional hunger, he explains here. Even though Ivan was very happy with the human beings, and human beings took very good care of him, but During night, when he was sleeping alone in his bed, he longed, means he wished for the company of a gorilla, and he wished to have a family of his own. He wished to have a companion like him, that he wanted to have another friend gorilla or more number of friends around him. But immediately one thought comes into his mind. What is that? Immediately he remembers what happened to Tad. She could not adjust to the new environment. She went into depression and she died. No, he remembers that thing and he consoles himself. Console means samadhana. He consoles himself that no, he should not think of the forest life. He should be adjusted to this human life, and he should survive in the human life only. Otherwise, the life of Ivan may end. He thinks like that. That emotional hunger. He longs another company of another gorilla. He wants a company of another gorilla sometimes. That is the emotional hunger he longs for. And later, when he grows up, Mark and Helen, they could not keep him at home. He was sent into a stationary circus in a shopping mall. And he completely forgot his wildlife and he was adjusted to the human environment. And till 27 years, he was there only. And what happened to his further life and all, you have to read the complete novel of Ivan, that is One and Only Ivan.
Before coming into the theme of the lesson, let's divide this lesson into two parts, then and now. If gorilla had brought up in the wild, how it would be? He would have brought up among the gorillas. There will be so many gorillas around them. But here in human, now he is living in between humans. There he has a playmate. That is, he has a playmate, his sister, that is Tag. He used to play happily with her. But here he has brought up as a only one child and he was alone. There he used to learn what all the things gorillas learn over there with the parents. But here he is learning so many other human activities here by looking at humans. There he used to lead a natural life over there, and here he is living a artificial life among human beings. There he used to live in freedom, but here he is living in captivity. Finally, the theme of the lesson is a question for we people. That is, are we right in trapping wild animals and taming them? Is it right to capture or trap the animals and making them to do the things whatever we need for our pleasure? Is it right? That is the question mark over here, and we people should decide that. This is a question from the author, that is Catherine Applegate, to we people. Is it right in trapping wild animals and taming them? That's all about the lesson, Ivan story. If you want to know more about Ivan, go through the complete novel, One and Only Ivan. Thank you, children.